Hello everyone and welcome back to another episode of Ben's Aquariums. Today we're going to be learning how to create and prepare some leaf litter for our aquariums. What I should talk about first is that every single person is going to prepare their leaf litter differently. However, the way that I'm going to be doing it is per the specifications of the company that I ordered the leaf litter through, and they're not a channel sponsor. But oh my God, I have learned so much from this company. It's Tannin Aquatics, and Scott is always there in the Instagram DMs answering my questions as I'm going through all of this. And this company I've learned so much from. So let's get into it. It would only be appropriate, since we're making some brown water for our fish tanks, if I was to drink some coffee out of my favorite mug, Life Sucks. So, the botanicals we're going to be using today are these three different types. They are live oak leaf litter. It's just a mixture of different leaves and twigs and little stems. And then the other one are these oak twigs. And then I got these very small catawba leaves. Now, this might look like a ton of leaves to be putting into a fish tank at once, and you're right, I'm not gonna put all of these in at once. We're going to gradually increase the leaf litter in there. Now, I am still learning about all of the protective and ecosystem enhancing benefits of leaf litter in the aquarium, but so far what I have learned is that all of this leaf litter increases the biofilms in your aquarium, which in turn increases grazing substrates for all the microscopic and macroscopic organisms that are in your aquarium, especially if you're breeding fish. This could be a game changer for you. The other things that it improves is that it makes the aquarium more interactive for your fish. For example, I have an Epistogramma McMasteri in my 22-gallon and some corys in my 16-gallon with Ruby. The second I added leaf litter, the Episto was out and about looking all over the aquarium, foraging through the leaf litter, and the corys were just like all around it, going after, I'm sure, all the little tiny microscopic cyclops and ostracods and daphnia that I'm sure are growing all over that leaf litter. So leaf litter is a really big game changer. It's just go slow. So now that you've boiled your leaf litter for about 60 minutes, you're going to strain out that old water and replace it with new water. And as the card says, to maintain domestic tranquility, you're going to put your tannins into a specified soaking pot. And you're gonna let it soak for 12 hours. So that's all of the leaf litter that we're gonna be adding today, is this little chunk spot we got right here. We're not gonna do this fast by any means at all, because when you add all this leaf litter, the ensuing decomposition of the leaves can drastically alter your oxygen levels of your tank and raise the CO2, and Theodore is like so dear to my heart that I don't wanna screw it up. So. The end goal is a leaf litter path that goes back down into there to add some contrast. And so if you like what I did in this video and you want to follow along for more updates, make sure to turn on that bell icon, because I don't have a set upload schedule. That is something that I would like to work on to give some consistency to all of you. And thank you so much for watching. I appreciate any kind of support you're willing to hand over, and I hope you have a wonderful day. Bye.